ever wondered about your life and wondered if you were heading in the right direction with it, and perhaps thought to yourself, I wish that I could experience God, or I wish I could have some kind of a life-changing experience that would be so stunning and so remarkable, it would turn me around 180 degrees and send me off in some new and more exciting direction. There were people who had that experience. The people who encountered Jesus of Nazareth had their lives completely turned around when they discovered within him something so fresh and so wonderful, they could not resist its pull. In him, they met God in a way that they had never seen God before, a God of boundless compassion and mercy and grace. And in Jesus, they encountered God as that which cares for the humble and the poor and the broken. And they encountered God when they realized that they also could care for the poor and the weak. And that experience changed them completely. Jesus was the power that turned their lives around 180 degrees. And what he brought to those people that was so refreshing and such a change were three simple little things. He brought forgiveness to them. And when they said, "Why are you forgiving everyone?" the answer that is implicit in his life is this. We forgive everyone because we are all sinners, we are all broken, and therefore we should all be generous with forgiving the people around us. That was new and fresh and exciting for those people, and they received the message with great joy. Then Jesus said, "We should love each other." And they said, "Why should we love each other?" And Jesus' answer is, because every person is absolutely precious and valuable. Not just the high and mighty who rule over you, but the little child and the weak and the poor and the outcasts and the refugees and the broken people. Love them simply because they are worth loving. And finally, he gave a message of hope, and they said, "Why should we have hope in this dismal world?" And he said, "Because each one of your lives has ultimate, eternal quality, quite apart from the reality of sickness and suffering and death." So he gave them forgiveness and love and hope, things they had never experienced before, and it spun them around and sent them off in exciting new directions. We have to be careful with the things that Jesus gave us, because if we twist them just a little bit, they become the opposite of what they should have been. For example, if we talk too much about the fact that we are sinful, it appears we are laying a burden of useless and hurtful guilt on people. Jesus didn't talk about our sin to crush or hurt us, but simply to give us a bit of humility and to make us sympathetic for the sins of others. If we talk too much about love, we might begin to think that we are loving people who have become perfect. We are not. We will never fully love as God intended. But Jesus gave that message so we should know what we ought to be. And when it comes to that message of hope, because our lives have eternal significance, if we twist that little bit, what we're saying is, if you're a good person, you will go to heaven, and that hope becomes a reward which can be used to manipulate people. That's not what Jesus intended. Jesus was giving those simple things that feed the human soul. Jesus was the ultimately non-religious person. He had no systems, he had no ceremonies, he had no rites. He had those things for which the human heart hungers very, very deeply.